Another picture-perfect rocket launch from Cape Canaveral. The military sent a Delta II rocket into space.
The rocket's carrying a sophisticated GPS satellite for the U.S. Air Force. Our space expert Dan Bello joins us live right now with much more on that. Hi, Dan.
Hi, Wendy. And so far, this has all just been made to order, just like the weather, with the satellite right now on its way to a perch 11,000 miles high.
EEA, ready. ESYS, ready.
FMA. It's the ninth ready. Delta to fly in this busy year for launches at the Cape. The only delay was a short 5-minute wait to avoid a collision with orbiting space junk overhead. The rocket rattled windows and turned heads on the space coast, especially at nearby Port Canaveral. Six of the nine booster rockets ignited at liftoff and burned for 60 seconds.
Burnout of the air start motors. Ignition of the air start.
On the ground, a small brush fire sprang up, ignited by the fiery exhaust. The last of the three boosters peeled off 2 minutes into the launch. The rocket is carrying a global positioning satellite, familiar to many who use computerized maps in cars or boats. You may not know when you use GPS, you're borrowing it from the military. Its main purpose is pinpoint targeting for bombs and missiles. The Pentagon must replenish the GPS satellite network as the satellites run out of fuel. This is the 57th GPS satellite. And in just a couple of minutes, the second stage of that rocket will be releasing that satellite into space. Only then will we know whether the launch was a success. We're live at the Cape. Dan Bello, WESH 2 News.
Thanks, Dan.